Raffi Torres has been suspended 41 games for an illegal check to the head on Jakob Silfverberg in Saturday night's preseason game. The suspension is the third longest for an on-ice incident in NHL history and the longest since Marty McSorley's one-year ban in 2000. Torres was given a match penalty on the play. It's his fifth career suspension. He will forfeit over $440,000 in salary. So here's how it sits in terms of the longest suspensions in the NHL. Third longest in NHL history. Torres has been suspended a combined 74 games in his career. He's forfeited almost $670,000. Marty McSorley was originally handed a 23-game suspension in 2000 for his stick-swinging attack on Donald Brashear. That suspension was later extended to a full year by NHL Commissioner Gary Bettman. Chris Simon received a 30-game suspension for stomping on Penguins forward Jarkko Ruutu with his skate in 2007. He was also suspended 25 games in March of 2007 for a two-handed attack to the face of Rangers forward Ryan Holwing.
All right, thank you. With Ray Ferraro, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie, it should really come as no surprise that Raffi Torres gets a lengthy suspension. He is the perfect candidate, multiple repeat offender, lengthy suspensions before, and the hit was ugly. But that number, 41, still seemed to take people aback a little bit. Is it the right number?
It surprised me, but yeah, sure, it's the right number. I mean, I don't know exactly what the perfect number is, but you got a player that has made multiple hits in the same variation for a number of years. It's really tough to have any sympathy for Raffi Torres at this point. This type of hit makes me sick. It's been tried to be outlawed from the game for a number of years. You're never going to make the game perfectly, but the severity of the suspension for Raffi Torres and his participation in the NHL, which has now been limited to at least the back 41 games of the season, shouldn't supersede the guys that are trying to play, and you got a guy headhunting him as he does on time and time again. Oh, the fact that Torres can't or won't change, good for the NHL for whacking them big.
Yeah, you've got to drop the hammer and hand down this massive suspension. Unfortunately for Raffi Torres, when he locks in on a target, he just can't stop himself and pull up. I have no idea why a left winger is going over there to make that hit. That's somebody else's responsibility. And time again, you see Hossa, the puck's gone, he's locked in, he just can't seem to pull up and make a clean check. Therefore, the league's got to step in and hand down this massive suspension. That sends a message. If you're just going to give a slap on the wrist, nobody gets the message. But this one, they get the message.
Keep in mind that under the new collective bargaining agreement, any suspension longer than 5 games is subject to independent arbitration if the player or the National Hockey League Players Association so chooses to appeal that once it's been appealed to NHL Commissioner Gary Bettman.
Much different issues for Zack Kassian of the Montreal Canadiens, who was in a car accident, a broken foot, broken nose, but his troubles go well beyond that?
Well, I certainly think so. At this point, I mean, the Montreal Canadiens are obviously disappointed. If you saw Mark Bergevin's news conference, he very disappointed in the decisions that Zack Kassian made. Now, the Montreal Canadiens knew that when he came over from the Vancouver Canucks, he was coming with some off-ice baggage, and that, of course, came to fruition in the form of the car crash on Sunday morning and the broken nose and broken foot in hospital. We expect to get some sort of clarification here in the next little while from the National Hockey League and or the Montreal Canadiens on the exact status of Zack Kassian, but I think it's fair to say at this moment in time that Kassian's concerns and problems go deeper than just a broken foot and a broken nose, so we'll stay tuned on that front.
Remember when he was traded during the free agent frenzy to the Montreal Canadiens, and he came on with us and said this was a wake-up call being traded, and he really thought this was the place he had to salvage his career. This certainly a large and unfortunate step back.